It's a full song Eucharist, so lots of lovely singing from the choir. Do join in if you know the pieces. And I'm asked to give a special thank you to everyone who came yesterday to clean the brass and the silver. Have a look around and enjoy the clean brass and silver, and many thanks from the church family. Our opening hymn, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind. Please let's sing. Greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and and the prophets.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Please be seated. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate thoughts. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is our past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's stand and sing the Gloria.
The first lesson is from Psalm 107, verses 23 to 32. Some went out on the sea in ships. They were merchants on the mighty waters. They saw the works of the Lord, his wonderful deeds in the deep. For he spoke and stirred up a tempest that lifted high the waves. They mounted up to the heavens and went down to the depths. In their peril, their courage melted away. They reeled and staggered like drunkards. They were at their wits' end. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he brought them out of their distress. He stilled the storm to a whisper. The waves of the sea were hushed. They were glad when it grew calm, and he guided them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. Let them exalt him in the assembly of the people and praise him in the council of the elders. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel is from Mark chapter 4, verses 35 to 41. That day, when evening came, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along, just as he was, in the boat. There were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat, so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet. Be still." Then the wind died down and was completely calm. He said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" They were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Today's passage from Mark chapter 4. They get in the boat, go out on the lake, and a great storm springs up. Now, by the way, Lake Galilee is prone to sudden storms, and the disciples are afraid. Remember that some of them were fishermen. They knew this lake, and even they were afraid. Meanwhile, Jesus is asleep. It's a lovely picture. So they wake him up and they say, "Hey, we're about to drown. Don't you care?" Jesus gets up, rebukes the wind, and tells the waves, "Quiet, be still." And it became completely calm. Now, for those with ears to hear, the echoes from the Old Testament are there. God's power over the elements, over the raging seas. The Israelites were not a great seafaring nation, not like the Greeks. For them the sea was a fearful place and the home of monsters. Even Lake Galilee had its dangers. So they wrote these prayers, these psalms. In Greville, we used to go to La Roca Harbour once a year, at about this time of year, for a service of blessing the boats. And Psalm 107 is a reading that we used each year. We called it the Sailor's Psalm. And in Psalm 107, we have people going out to sea in ships. We have merchants going about their business, seeing the works of the Lord. But then things go terribly wrong. The sea swells and rages. They are tossed to and fro. They stagger about like drunkards. And they cry out to the Lord in their trouble. And it says he stilled the storm to a whisper. There's a good strong echo. That is very similar to what we read in Mark 4. So when we read a passage in Mark, like the calming of the storm, it's very vivid in its own right, but it also has these echoes from the Old Testament that we need to be aware of. Because when we remember those lovely psalms, what they tell us is, this is how God does things. It is God who has this power over nature. Did you notice the disciples' reaction when it all went calm? They were terrified. We may well ask, were they more afraid during the storm or afterwards in the calm? Their reaction is not, thank goodness we are safe. Nor is it, well, this Jesus is very cool to sleep through a storm like that. No, their reaction is, who is this man who behaves as God behaves, who does what only God can do? Just who are we dealing with here? I don't think I've mentioned it before, but I like to give a title to each of the Gospels to help me remember its key features and how each one presents Jesus. So, Matthew is the most Jewish of the four. King of the Jews is my title for Matthew. Luke highlights the human compassion of Jesus. Son of Man is a good title there. Meanwhile, John, well, he highlights the divinity of Jesus. Son of God is the title for John. But with Mark, it is slightly different. My title, this one, is a question. Who is this man? Because that question runs like a thread through the early chapters of Mark. The people see Jesus forgiving sins, and they ask, is this blasphemy? Only God can do that. They see him cast out demons. I think that's where we were 2 weeks ago. And they ask, well, is he in league with Satan? He heals people with a touch or a word. He has power over nature. Even the wind and the waves obey him. Who is he? So the Gospel of Mark is cleverly written as the unfolding story of who Jesus really is. At the start, when Jesus calls the first disciples, they just do not know who he is. And he doesn't tell them. They see him doing amazing things, but they're not yet able to put two and two together. From time to time, Jesus teases them, perhaps with growing frustration. Don't you understand yet? He says to them, do you still have no faith? only later in the story do they start to get the picture. Peter realizes that Jesus is the Messiah. And only at the very end does someone realize the deeper truth. He is not just the Messiah, but the Son of God. So the incident of the calming of the storm plays its own part in the unfolding story. But let's bring our thoughts back to the Psalms. One of the benefits of the Psalms is that they have much to teach us about prayer. Nearly all of them are prayers, displaying a wide range of human emotions, as the poet pours out his concerns to God, showing us that we too can do the same. We can be genuine with God, utterly honest, open with him. See, I don't know if you will call this another sort of echo, but there are a few psalms where the poet says, "Wake up, God, we need some help here." Here's a good example. It's from Psalm 44. "Awake, O Lord, why do you sleep? Rouse yourself, rise up and help us." Well, I'm not sure if I've ever prayed a prayer quite like that, but I have certainly prayed to God with real urgency from time to time in my life. "Lord, please, I need some help." Our prayers are not to a God who is distant and detached, but rather to a God who is right here for us, just as Jesus was right there for the disciples to call on him. When the disciples called on Jesus, they got rather more than they bargained for, and it left them with some questions to answer. When we pray to God openly like this, we do not always get what we want, but what God wants. What he wants for us and perhaps from us. It may be that we are the ones who need a wake-up call. It may bring us to realize afresh just who Jesus is and who we are and where we fit in to the bigger picture. So let's come to an end. There may be storms of some kind going on in our lives now. Let's go from here today, knowing that we can pray this sort of prayer. We can wake the Lord up and call on him for help. And then we wait and see what he will do. But we have to be prepared to hear all the echoes of what is going on. And in the light of those, we must follow him wherever he leads us. Please let's stand for the creed together. We believe in one God, the Father, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and
Let us pray. Lord God, you are the Father of all people, and we bring our prayers knowing that you will hear us and help us. Hear our prayer, Lord, for the whole family of the Church, and grant that we and all your people may be built up in our faith and always show in our lives the love we see in Jesus. As we prepare for the service of the commemoration of the veterans of the Peninsula War and the Battle of Waterloo, we ask for your divine intervention throughout the coming week. Continue to guide the committee, the leaders, and all those due to travel for this very special occasion. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our island and the many freedoms which we enjoy. We pray for the Queen and for those who govern in her name. Give them health and strength, wisdom and courage, so that they may carry out their many duties in the best interests of all people. We also remember those whose lives have been shattered by natural disasters. We ask for your blessing on all those who have lost their homes, their livelihoods, their security, and their hope. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for one another. Help us to grow together in faith and love, rejoicing in your fatherhood, for children and young people, and those who are eager and active as they explore and welcome new experiences and relationships, and those more shyly weighing up their first steps. We think of young people whose ability and circumstances allow them to accept their daily challenges and opportunities. We think of all children and young people, praying that they may be worthy of the best in our society, and society worthy of their potential. And today, our thoughts and prayers are with Anu and Ben, who are to be married in this wonderful church on Saturday. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear our prayer, Lord, for people who are ill, in hospitals, at home, or wherever they may be. Give them courage, hope, and peace, and the knowledge that you are present in their weakness, pain, and suffering. May the skills and knowledge of those who care for the sick be fully used to help and to heal. And we pray today for those whom we now mention: Lolly Ann Greeny, Jeff Ainuff, Ray Kitchen, David Bishop, Ed Churchill, Desi and John Campbell. And in a moment of silence, let us pray for all who have no one to pray for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those we love but no longer see. Grant them your peace and let light perpetual shine upon them. We remember before God those who have died, and today we give thanks to the life of Jenny Novaski. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Many thanks to Sylvie. Please then stand and share the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great purpose to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Show us your glory as far as we can grasp it, and shield us from knowing more than we can bear, until we may look upon you without fear, through Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen. And then together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Very appropriate to those storms at sea. Eternal Father, strong to save. Son and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.